Great right now, though, to catch up with San Diego State softball coach in her first season as head coach, long time on the Mesa, Stacey Neuveman Deniz, who did a whale of a job this year with the Aztec softball program, longtime assistant, one of the great softball players ever. Again, with San Diego State as a head coach, taking the Aztecs to a regional that'll kick off tomorrow against LSU at 5 p.m. on ESPNU in Tempe. Aztecs in a regional for the first time since 2015. And again, Stacey Neuveman Deniz with us right now on John and Jim. Coach, it is great to have you with us on the home of the Aztecs. Congratulations on a special season. I think it's been led, and tell me if I'm wrong, by your pitching staff with incredible numbers. Is that the primary reason, the starting pitching and the pitching overall, that's gotten you to this point?
Well, first of all, thanks for having me. I'm excited to be here and spend a little time talking about my team and the awesome things that we're doing. But to your point, you know, we've been very fortunate to have solid pitching in the circle. And anybody that knows softball in particular, but baseball is much the same. You know, if you've got solid arms in the circle, you're off to a good start without the game even, you know, kicking off yet. So, you know, I think that's been a huge part of our success is that we've had, we've had stellar pitching performances pretty much week in and week out. We've had an excellent staff who's led by our fifth year senior Maggie Ballant. Actually, today was named first team All Region, so she's knocking on the door of potential All American accolades and doing everything you could ask her to do in the circle. Obviously, I think that's big. The next piece I would say that I think is really contributing to the special season we're having is just the sort of cultural, I guess, reset, you might say. The team has really bought into some of the new things we've kind of introduced and the new concepts and the buy-in to team first, us over I, me, and things of that nature. So I think that's a big piece of it as well. You know, it's a lot of the same athletes that we had in the past, but I think there's a new kind of refreshed sense of excitement and passion for the program and really excited to take it to the next level.
Coach, congrats on the season so far. You personally won a national championship at UCLA in 1999. What does it take to win a national championship, in your sport?
Well, I got to say, you know, it's different now than it once was. Uh-huh. Back in the day, first of all, we didn't have a super regional, so you went to a regional site. If you won your regional tournament, you went straight to the World Series. So it's a little bit different. The grind has gotten greater. It's a grind to get yourself all the way to the big show is not easy. You've got to play 3 weekends. You've got to grind out against, you know, obviously top teams and short turnarounds. You know, you're playing back-to-back games, in some cases multiple games in a day. So it's not for the faint of heart, that's for sure. As anyone would say, championship softball is pitching, defense, and timely hitting. And, you know, right now we're dialed in on the pitching and defense. I think the timely hitting is always the challenge. It's the team that can get those clutch hits in those big moments. And we've had our share, you know, to get us to this point. We had a tough conference, a three-horse race, as they say, with ourselves, UNLV, and Boise State. We were fortunate to win out, you know, in terms of getting the better of those two programs. But it's a team effort, and, you know, we've had different heroes in different moments and different days, and I think that's going to be very character building for us as we come into this because, you know, you look at the teams that get it done consistently, you know, you can't just be a top-heavy lineup. You've got to get production from, you know, 1 through 9, and as I said, performances in the circle as well. So I think we're in good shape. We're playing good ball, and very excited to be here and really just going to soak it all in, enjoy the moment, and go out tomorrow and bring our best.
37-14 for the Aztecs this year, 20-4 in the league. Aztecs, LSU Tigers tomorrow at 5 p.m. on ESPNU, kicking off the regional in Tempe. I want to say this is the highest rated RPI regional in the country that San Diego State's going to be playing in this week. And Coach, I know you've been around this program for a long time. You've been around a lot of really good San Diego State teams that have been to the NCAA tournament. How does this team differ from some of those teams?
I think the newness of it is to our advantage. We've missed out on the postseason the last handful of years. And so there are people on this team that have been a part of this program for 5 years and have never been to a regional, have never competed in the postseason. So I think that you can call it novelty, but I think it's fresh eyes. You know, there's nothing being taken for granted by this group. You know, we're going up against opponents that go to the postseason every year. Frankly, I think LSU, this is the first time in like 7 or 8 years they haven't hosted a regional. So they are not just postseason regulars, but they're typically playing at home. So for those programs, and you know, in ASU and Cal State Fullerton, they're year in and year out postseason teams, to their credit. For us, we're getting back to where we want to be. So I think we have the advantage of being being the green pups that don't know any better. We're just going to come in and play our game with very little pressure, and you know, and embrace that underdog role. And I think if we can do that, we can beat anybody in the country.
Yeah, you mentioned LSU. They have a lot of experience in this tournament. You guys are facing them on Friday to kick off the regionals. What are the keys for you guys beating LSU?
Well, LSU's got a legit offense. They put up some significant offensive numbers, not to mention they have a pretty deep pitching staff as well, with two or three complementary arms that have you know, great experience in the SEC. You know, they obviously play a tough conference schedule. They play a tough non-conference schedule. So for a team like that, it's for us, we got to come out and play our best ability, with play loose, have fun, enjoy the moment. If we get tight and we put too much pressure on ourselves, I think that's a recipe for disaster for us. So we play loose, and hopefully they play tight. They play like they have expectations. They play to you know, to not to lose rather than playing to win. I know that's a kind of an odd comment, but you know, that's what we talk about, is we got to play to win the game. We're not trying to not lose it. And I think when you're the underdog, you get the luxury of being in that role, as opposed to the team that's quote unquote supposed to win. You know, they want to be home right now. They're in Tempe, Arizona. So that's got to play a little bit something in their game plan, and maybe in their mindset as well. For us, we are thrilled to be here. And again, we're kind of enjoying the role of underdog, and we're going to embrace that.
Coach, congratulations on an amazing first year on the Mesa as the head coach. Best of luck this weekend in trying to get San Diego State softball program out of a regional for the first time in school history. We will be watching tomorrow night and this weekend. It's San Diego State and LSU from Tempe on ESPNU at 5 p.m. Best of luck, Coach, this weekend. We look forward to doing it again soon.
Thanks, Coach.
John, Jim, thanks so much.